the chambers of hell. I bless the Lord who enabled us to reveal mysteries of these chambers of hell to his church, hoping that no one will be lost. The Lord has raised a generation of teacher. He said, I am not the one that judge you, it's the word I taught you. These words will manifest in the day of judgment to testify against you if you fail to obey. In the day of judgment the Lord will call every pastor with all the souls that heard his teaching, to be judged through the man of God. If the man of God has carried out his mission of teaching these souls sound doctrine, he will be innocent of their blood. If he had failed to teach them sound doctrine that can save their souls, he will be held accountable for their souls and will be damned. If the man of God had taught the biblical word and sound doctrine but his members had failed to follow his teaching, these people will perish. Make no mistake, beloved, there will be 3 degrees of judgment. God will judge your conduct in relation to your body, and if you are victorious. Secondly, God will judge your soul, the inner man. When you come out victorious, he will finally judge your spirit. Many believers will be disqualified on that day. Maybe you will triumph in terms of outward conduct, but in the second degree of judgment the Lord will look at your inside, the inner man. If you overcome in the soul, then the Lord will judge you spirit. Therefore we must always be preparing, brother. We must begin to prepare our eternity now. Only sound doctrine that can help us to go to heaven. The Lord will judge you by your conduct and also on the basis of what you have heard. After living under the veil, the church must understand its spiritual part. One day we shall enter the spiritual world, therefore we must arrange our spiritual life. Brother, beside this life there is another life after death. People that have gone beyond the grave before us are either in the place of torment or in the place of rest. They are conscious of their loved ones that are left on the earth. We must seriously think and ponder where we will spend our eternity. Eternity is something many ignore, yet we are pilgrims and stranger on the land, living in a material body that is temporary. This body is comparable to garment that we wear. One day we will leave this body, that is an envelope. What matter to men is their final destination. Inside men there is something that will not pass, that will live forever, which is the soul, the inner man. Your soul will live forever. You are not the exterior, which is simply an envelope, but you are the interior that is eternal. Man is a spirit. The interior man does not need beauty and material stuff. That's what your envelope demand. Even if you went to university and got many diploma, you are only satisfying your body, which is not you but your envelope. You are not meeting the need of the inner man. What matter in men is the interior. Your path and works are predetermined by the Lord in advance. The issue with the Lord is not how long you live on the earth. We can see that even righteous men don't always live longer. The Lord wants you to go to heaven. The time given to you is so that you can prepare yourself. In this experience, the Lord took me to a place where I saw many pits of fire with people inside, and he informed me that it was a place where people that sell items in the market in exaggerated price are damned forever. I saw that all these pits of fire were surrounded by boards upon which were written exaggerated prices of items. I observed these pits that went beyond the sight. The Lord said, we have to visit these souls. I want the world to be aware of all the realities that you will see here. Then we breached the thorns wire and quickly we saw the first soul that was condemned in his pit. I said, Lord, what has he done to be here? The Lord said, all the articles that he was selling on the earth, their average prices were well known. When an item was $20, people often bargained to get them at $15, but when this man was selling his goods, despite the fact that the prices of his items were well known, he was giving the prices of his items on the basis of people's appearance. Whenever he noticed that a customer seems richer, he was catapulting the price because the person that has come to buy seemed well off. This man was giving prices of items depending on people's appearance. He could distinguish the rich from the poor, and those who were richer were supposed to buy his good in exaggerated price, for they were rich, yet the item average price was well known. This is the reason his soul fell in hell. The Lord said, tell my people, all those who sell articles and items in exaggerated price have no portion in my kingdom. I like honest believer, but those who commit evil will not enter the kingdom of heaven. This is the fate of all these people that exaggerate the price and overcharge. Then we continue our journey. We saw another soul that was in the flame of hell. He was in the worst torment. I saw that he was really enduring unbearable pain. I said, "What has he done in the world to fall here?" The Lord said, "When he was in the world, her mother could not go to the market to do the shopping for the family. Therefore she charged him to do all the shopping for the family. Given that her mother was writing all the prices of these items that he was supposed to buy, her mother was giving the money on the basis of the average and known price. But whenever this man was going to the market, he was bargaining with seller, so that he would buy these items in lower price, in order to profit from the remaining money. Yet this was not his money, this was money made available by her mother for family expenditure. He got in the habit of bargaining with seller to get items in lower price and profit from money that does not belong to him. He should have returned the rest of the money to her mother, for they do not belong to him. It's her mother that was to decide whether to give him that money or not." I said, "Lord, if the judgment is this way, who can be saved? He has done nothing wrong." The Lord said, "Even if he bargained to get items in lower price, it's still not his money. He should have returned the money to his mother. His task was just to buy good and return the rest of money to his mother, for it does not belong to him." Then we went to the next pit, where I saw a lady, who was in extreme torment. Liquid fire and gruel were falling on her, and she was begging the Lord to save her. The Lord said she was a married woman. His husband was taking care of her. When she was pregnant, she told her husband, "Since I am feeling exhaustion, we need to employ a maid that can help us, so that what I cannot do, he would do it for me." The husband said to her, "I have no time. Just find a maid that you trust and I will pay his salary." When the maid came, he asked for a salary of $300, but the lady bargained with him and he accepted a salary of $250. This lady told the maid, "Don't tell my husband that your salary is $250, but I will be paying you that amount. I only want my husband to know that we have agreed a salary of $300, but every time my husband give me $300, I will pay you $250. Only for $50 will be mine." That is the way this lady was left with $50 every month, and she fell in hell as a result of dishonesty. Then the Lord took me to a place where I saw a man sitting inside a cauldron that was hit. The man was fighting to get out and he was screaming. The Lord said, "You have sinned and this is the wage of sin you are suffering." I said, "What has he done?" The Lord said he was in charge of doing provision for the family. Every day his mother gave him money to do the shopping for the family. The mother did not make a list of what he was to buy. She just gave him an amount that she thought was enough for daily provision, though this man was doing shopping that was enough for the family. Whenever some of money was left, he was using it for himself, instead of returning it. If only he could give back the money, he would not fall here in the place of torment. Many souls were stuck in this segment of hell because of overcharging. If you had done this, please return the money to your parent and confess. If you no longer have money to return, find something symbolic that has value in your eyes. If you have been lying to your customers, take what is considerable and get to see the pastor. Children, women, social network, cinematography and game, vanity and fashion, food, cooling, fornication and homo.